Hi, I'm Dr. Richard Usatine, Associate Editor of the Journal of Family Practice and Column Editor of Photo Rounds. I am a Professor of Family Medicine, Dermatology, and Cutaneous Surgery at the University of Texas Health Science Center in San Antonio. I'm also the Medical Director of the University Skin Clinic.
Today, we will demonstrate intralesional steroid injections. Intralesional injections of triamcinolone are a valuable tool in the treatment of many skin conditions, including acne, keloids, granuloma annulare, and alopecia areata. To create the right concentration for each injection, triamcinolone is often diluted with sterile saline. A 30-gauge needle is used to inject inflammatory acne lesions using a concentration of 2 mg per milliliter triamcinolone and an approximate volume of 0.1 milliliters per injection. Injection continues until the acne nodule or cyst is distended and may blanch white. The acne lesion, or other lesions, under pressure may squirt back at you, so eye protection is essential for these injections. The injections of keloids is performed with a 25-gauge to 27-gauge needle and triamcinolone in the concentration of 10 to 40 milligrams per milliliter. Sometimes it takes great pressure to inject the steroid into the firm keloid, and so it is helpful to have a lure lock syringe to avoid the needle from popping off the syringe during the procedure. The injection of granuloma annulare can be performed with a 30-gauge needle and 5 milligrams per milliliter triamcinolone. It is important that the triamcinolone is injected directly into the raised annular border. Risks of skin atrophy and hypopigmentation should be explained during the consent process for this and other steroid injections. Alopecia areata can be injected with 5 mg per milliliter of triamcinolone using a 27-gauge needle. Intralesional injections can be both effective and safe for the treatment of many skin lesions. The efficacy of these injections depends upon many factors, including the lesion duration and size. Acne injections are particularly effective with results visible in one day, while keloids and alopecia areata may not respond quickly and can require multiple injections. Granuloma annulare often responds well to a single treatment, but not as quickly as acne.